Kamusta mga kaibigan? Ito po ang Pisibilities, ang inyong gabay sa buhay pinansyal. I'm your host, Francisco Colaico. Noong isang linggo, usapin tungkol sa credit card ang ating tinalakay. We stress the importance of explaining to our children what a credit card is and what it is not. Halimbawa, ang credit card ay may tuturing na utang dahil hinihiram natin sa isang institusyon gaya ng bangko ang perang ginagamit nating pambayad kada swipe ng card. Credit cards are also tools of convenience. Pwedeng ituring itong electronic wallet, isang swipe lang, bayad na. Pero wallet na may limit sa paggastos o paggamit. Ngayon, kailangan din maunawaan ng mga anak natin what a credit card is not. Hindi libre ang paggastos sa mga bilihin porque hindi naglabas ng pera kapag ginamit ang credit card. Hindi rin ito paraan para makabili ng mamahaling luho na di naman kaya talaga ng budget. Tandaan na hindi unlimited ang paggamit nito dahil may tinatawag na credit limit ang bawat card na nagtatakda kung hanggang magkano lang ang pwede mong gamitin. Bago natin bigyan ang credit cards ang ating mga anak, siguraduhin nating bihasa na sila sa ilang financial skills, gaya ng goal setting, proper budgeting, pati na rin sa pag-ipon higit sa lahat. Mainam na ikonsideran din natin ang angkop na edad kung kailan sila dapat bigyan nito para sa responsabling paggamit. Ngayon linggo, pag-uusapan naman natin ang tungkol sa pagkakaroon ng ating mga anak ng sarili nilang bank account. Paulit-ulit ko pong sinasabi ang kahalagahan ng pag-ipon sa mga nakaraang episode ng Pisibilities. Savings is the first expense that buys your future. At para sa mga bata, nag-identify tayo ng tatlong dahilan para mahikayat silang mag-ipon. Una, para mabili nila ang kanilang gusto. Ikalawa, para ilaan sa kinabukasan. At ikatlo, upang maitulong sa mga nangangailangan. Kadalasan, piggy bank o saving jar ang pinalalagyan ng mga bata sa kanilang naipon. Kung nais nating simulan na ang pagiging aware ng ating mga anak tungkol sa konsepto ng wealth building, we need to emphasize that they need to protect their savings. This is where bank accounts come in. And having a bank account is an important milestone in a kid's financial journey. Sasamahan kayo muli ni Mr. Arman Benko sa pagtalakay sa ating usapin ngayong araw.
Welcome back. This is Arman Benko of the Colaico Foundation. For today, we have a special guest, Ms. Patricia Paterno. Kayo na siguro pag babanggitin ko nung business nyo, which has been here for the longest time. Ms. Patricia Paterno, you're the owner of?
Papemelroti.
Papemelroti. So, mahirap kasi yung where the accent should be.
Yes.
Kung ano yung Papemelroti?
We have several gift shops, 15 gift shops. We make a lot of things na for gifts, stationery,
anything related things. To paper ba? Parang yun yung nakita ko dati doon sa...
We have a lot of paper products.
Paper products.
We design it. Like, my son designs also. He's 19 years old and he designs. My niece. So, all of us, we design.
These are not for mass manufacture, mass produce?
Well, we mass produce it after it's designed.
Designed by members of the family?
Yes, but okay. Not everything, no? Because we get from subcontractors also.
Okay. And talking about family and our topic today, kids and kids opening bank accounts. Mm-hmm. You have one child?
Yes, I have.
Tell us something about the child.
Joshua is 19. He's taking computer science in UP.
Okay. Only child?
Only child.
Only child. 19 years old. Kailan siya una nagkaroon ng pagmumulat tungkol sa pera? You were saying mas importante sa inyo the concept
earning.
Of earning.
Yes.
When was the first time you entrusted or discussed money matters with Joshua?
When he was elementary, because I just followed my parents. No? My parents taught us how to earn money and to save. My parents did not, give us expensive things. We hardly had any toys. We would make our own toys.
Make your own toys?
Yeah. We would make our own toys from cardboard and catalogs that we cut up, paper dolls. We would make it. But I remember my father, he made us a bank book, each one of us. Mm-hmm. Okay, and it was so cute, you know.
It's a family passbook. Yeah. It's not a real passbook from a bank yet.
Yes, it's a homemade bank book. And it put down there our deposits and withdrawals. And then every Christmas, he would double the amount.
Okay.
So, of course, we were encouraged to save. And we were elementary. I don't exactly remember when he stopped, but I know he stopped because it was already too much to double. Okay. So I did the same with my son. Whatever he would save, I would double also.
Okay.
And then when it was enough, then we opened a bank account.
Elementary age.
Elementary age.
Okay. What was your first money lesson to Joshua? Money is to be earned.
Yes, exactly. Because I didn't want him to think that, you know, money was so easy that he could just ask for something and then he would. So all the time he would have to, you know, if he wanted something, he would have to save his allowance or he would have to earn money.
Okay.
And before, when he was young, the way he would earn was yung pakyaw in our store. When you just pack our paper products, because you have to put it in plastic. So that one, you get paid the minimal amount, and then you add it up, and then they get paid. And so that's how they earned. But now that he's older, he's good in design. And so he's been designing notebooks, calendars, bookmarks, posters, so he gets paid for that.
And medyo hindi na safe yung pasweldo dahil lang anak. Talagang
his designs are very good. They even get posted by customers in Instagram. Yeah. So we let him design because he's a good designer already.
Okay. And first money concept is money is to be earned, and then he has to save up.
Yes, he has to save up. So when the money was enough in the bank account, we put it also in mutual funds. So now he has a mutual funds account.
Investment account.
Yeah, investment account.
So from a savings account to an investment account. Mm-hmm. But share us your experience. How did you explain to Joshua the importance of having a bank account? Why a bank account? Why not just in mommy's purse or in the piggy bank para madali kong makuha?
Exactly. Because he would ask me, how come when we put it in the bank, we cannot get it out anymore? So that's precisely why we have that account. So that, you know, it's really kept safe there. Cannot be, you know, taken out at a whim or, you know. So that's my concept of savings. That when you put it there, it's there until,
keeps.
Yeah. Until, you know, maybe you're older and then it will increase. Because you have enough, like he can earn enough to buy, he always buys things, you know. I'm amazed at how much he can save actually to buy these games for his PlayStation or something. So, whatever, you know, is extra, then he can put it in savings.
Did you bring him to the bank? Dinalan mo ba siya sa branch?
No, I didn't.
Ah, you did not?
I didn't. No, because we have a relationship with the bank, so I just...
Kailan siya first nagkaroon ng experience going inside the bank? He has gone to a bank, obviously.
Yeah, well, I don't remember the first experience.
No, pero bata pa ba siya?
Yeah.
We made an informal survey. Mm-hmm. 10 kids who were able to get inside the bank.
Mm-hmm.
Alam mo, malaking bagay pala sa child yung merong ibang tao that they discuss money with, mm-hmm, na hindi nila kamag-anak.
Okay.
So, that was an experience for them because someone is calling them, sir, ma'am, mm-hmm, and bata pa sila, mm-hmm, 10, 12, 14 years old. And that is a big thing for them. Parang they are identified and recognized.
Mm-hmm.
Any problem or challenges?
Challenges, I think it's
because... Ano yung discussion nyo na medyo naging mainit about...
Yes, well, not naman mainit, but it's very difficult for a young person to understand the concept of saving because they don't already think, you know, in terms of the future.
Yeah.
So my sisters and I, we were thinking of inviting somebody from outside, a consultant, like from mutual funds company to explain to them so that it's not just us, you know. They might think, oh, that's just mom or that's just dad, you know. Right. So we've been thinking of that, but it has to be, you know, all together so that it's a fun activity. It's not like a lecture.
Right, right. And dictated by the parents. Ano?
Yes.
And yung sa bank account, has he maintained the first bank account that
yes, it's still there,
still
but
there.
Then it's already less because we put it in mutual funds in his name.
Okay.
Before, it was like held in trust, and so I'm changing it now to because he's an adult already. So,
yung mga banking transactions, is he given the leeway to do the banking transactions? Kailan mag-deposit? Kailan mag-withdraw?
Well, it will only be deposited if he gives me money to...
So, sekretarya ka pa ng... Sekretarya ka pa na yun.
Because I was asking him, Josh, do you remember when we started? I can't remember because he was very young.
Yeah.
So he doesn't really remember. But he knows the value of saving because in the house, he has a bank. Mm-hmm. And so he saves
bank.
His money in the bank. I think it's one of those banks with the, you know, with compartments
with
you save.
Different sleeves.
Yeah. So he has savings and then he has for saving up for something. So he has different compartments. I just leave him to that. And then whatever he can save, he gives to me. So that, because I have somebody also who goes to the bank. So.
Right. Okay. When we will pause for a break, but when we come back, share with us, what do you intend to do? Do you plan to teach him to have another bank account for his own use? At gusto mo na bang ma-expose na? Ma-expose na siya na siya na yung pumupunta sa bank. He's 19 years old
yes,
now.
Yes,
yes. And yung transition from a savings account to an investment account, pag-usapan natin
okay.
More deeply after we pause for a short break. Huwag po kayong aalis. Peaceabilities will still be back.
Isu mo, palaguin mo.
My strong suggestion, bring your child to the bank. Let the child experience yung bank personnel greeting them. Sir, ma'am, imagine at 7 years old.